Hello, this is Scott Woods, and today we're going to be talking about the hypothetical process of moving a load as a freight broker or a freight broker agent. Now, I've broke this process down into a step process, a structure, if you will, so that anyone, whether you're a new freight broker or maybe a freight broker agent, so you will know the process involved and the things that are going to be required before you can actually move a load effectively. Now, step one, of course, is you're contacting your potential prospects, your potential customers, and you're going to offer your services of a freight broker. You're going to give him your initial sales presentation, and hopefully he's going to agree to use your services. Now, of course, you're going to have a number of questions that you will be asking him. One of those questions is, does he have any freight available? Now, if he agrees to give you some freight, you'll also need to know some more information. You'll need to know the trailer type that it might run on, or the trailer that he is requesting. You'll need to know how much the load weighs, where is it picking up, where it's going. Also, if there's going to be pallets required, maybe it needs tarping if it's an open top load that will go on a flatbed or a step deck, and any accessorial items that may or may not be included, such as lumper fees with that and possible additional stops. Now, once you've gathered all of the information, you're going to basically confirm that. You'll send him your information so he can keep it on file, because what you're doing in essence is building a customer database. Well, step two, he's offered you the load. Now, what do you do now? You've got all the required information, so now you have to go find a carrier for it. Well, you want to go and put the load on a load board, such as Internet Truck Stop or DAT. You'll post all the load particulars and details on there, such as what type of equipment, the days it's picking up, where it's picking up at, and where it's going to. Now, Once you've posted the load on the load board, you're going to start contacting carriers to offer him the freight. Now, if your customer has given you a pre-assigned rate that he is trying to meet, well, you'll know exactly what to start offering these carriers, because you can't give them all the money because you have to make money yourself. So you will take your percentage off of that load amount and start searching for a carrier offering him that price. Now, if you cannot attain a carrier for that rate, I suggest that you at least attain a carrier's price to pull the load. Then at that point in time, if you have located a carrier to pull the load, you've got a rate in mind, you'll go on to step four, which is you'll contact the customer and either agree to his rate, or you will provide the rate that you can get the load transported for. All right, and that's the negotiation process that's going to, you know, start to see if you can actually get the freight from the shipper. Now, if he does agree to your freight rate, whether you've matched his rate that he needs or whether he agrees to the new freight rate that, you know, you can actually get it transported for, you're going to go into the next step. Now, step five, he's going to approve the rate. So at this point in time, you're going to do a couple of different things. All right. You're going to talk to your shipper, go over all the final load details, make sure he's good with the rate. Once again, you're just going to reaffirm it. Then you're going to contact the motor carrier of which you had spoken with earlier and tell him the load's good to go. Now, here's where the paperwork is going to begin. Now, you're going to send the shipper a setup package. Now, that is, if he is not already set up within your system, you will send the shipper a setup package. There'll generally be a broker shipper agreement in there, and also a credit request. He'll fill out the broker shipper agreement, he'll fill out the credit request, and if you or your brokerage have a process for signed freight quote sheets prior to loads moving, you'll also have him sign off on that. Now, the freight quote you'll actually prepare and send to him as well. Now, once he does all that, he'll return all the paperwork to your office so you can check his credit. Now, if he's already set up, you're going to skip this step. Now, at the same time, you're also going to send the motor carrier setup package to complete and return. He's going to have to fill out the broker carrier agreement, the company profile, get his payment information, get, of course, all of his trailer information, his driver information, because you're going to have to provide this to the shipper so he could create a bill of lading for this. Now, the motor carrier will return all of the paperwork you send him, as well as he will return a copy of his operating authority, his W-9, and also a copy of his insurance. You need to be assured and contact his insurance company, as well as work with the dispatcher to have your brokerage listed as a certificate holder or additionally insured on the load. That way you're going to be covered and you don't have to kick in and get contingency cargo insurance on your own. If you work with this policy, you're going to save you some money by doing so as a brokerage. But this is actually an agent responsibility in most cases. You always have the brokerage listed as an additionally insured or a certificate holder on the carrier's policy before you give him that load. Now, if the carrier is already set up in your database, of course, you will skip that step. Now, we're going to finalize the process right here, because step 9 with this, once all of the paperwork has been completed by the shipper, he's passed a credit check, you know, you can proceed to the next step. Now, if you're factoring your freight, the factoring company will let you know how much the shipper's credit is. So when you're setting the shipper up in your database, you'll have to save that information to make sure he doesn't go over your credit on the next load. Now, you've got all the paperwork back, he's going to be good to go. You'll proceed to the last step, which is sending the carrier the rate confirmation. Now, you will only send this rate confirmation if you have had all the motor carrier's paperwork returned, you've checked his insurance out, you've checked his safety rating out, you've looked at his SMS score through CSA. You want to do your proper due diligence and make sure the carrier is going to be able to pull the load safely without giving you any further problems. Guys, that's how you move a load. It's redundant. You do this step by step by step on every load that you'll move. If you set up a proper structure similar to this as an agent or as a freight broker, you're going to find that it's a pretty seamless transition on what you're going to be doing in moving your freight. You will not only write more freight, because you'll be in constant communication with the shippers, constant communication with the carriers. It'll just make it an altogether easy process. Thank you for viewing this video.